charge straight away, and this game is Ryan just struggles to control that puck as he comes into the zone, and the Stingrays have cleared out. Well, it's good puck control here, and then one-on-one on the goal already, and Hull Stingrays and scores in the first minute of the goal of the game. Hull Stingrays go 1-0 ahead with 37 seconds on the clock.
And there you go, they are definitely trying to get themselves that win tonight. Quite impressive. Lauzon's second goal in two nights. He scored against Edinburgh last night in a 5-2 defeat. But you know, there's plenty of time for the Dundee Stars to get back in the game.
Takes it across the blue line, finds McCloskey, moves into the face of circle, takes a shot. Goal at the top of the goal, though. Kept in the zone by the Stars. Mitchell goes down to the right hand side. Finds Mugalski in the corner. Under a bit of pressure. Still got the puck, finds Mitchell in a bit of space. Shoots and scores! Good finish from John Mitchell there. It's 1-1 with 18 minutes and 26 seconds to go in the first period. A first goal very quickly on the clock for the Stingrays. And another one for the Stars just as quick, it's one each.
And if there ever was a time for the Dundee Stars to get themselves back, it would be right at the start of the game. Showing what they mean tonight, that's impressive.
Centre, takes it into the corner, he's not really got any support at the moment, just awaiting his teammates coming in. Stingrays got Brady from the point, shot, hard save, excellent the rebound, Arvato makes it 2-1, Hull Stingrays with 12 minutes and 37 seconds left in the first period.
That was quite a bit of impressive play from the Hull Stingrays to put himself 2-1 in front. Got to give them credit, they knew exactly where each other were and they knew where they were putting that puck. And you've got to say Mark Chevrolet stood no chance of saving that one.
The rebound pops out in front, and it's just luck if someone's there to take advantage or not. And the Dundee Stars were unlucky in that instance. Koski moves out to the left hand side. Here come the Stars at pace, out of the zone. James forward. Over into the corner and a check there into the boards, and the referee puts his hand in the air immediately. There's been a few of those in the last few days, as we've all seen in the Elite League, and the referees don't like them. And there's a couple there of guys squaring up to each other by the looks of things. I think that's Mitchell.
It's all happening.
Yep. Hutchins takes over for Dundee Stars. Less than 30 seconds on the clock before the end of the first period. Punches are still going on the left hand side. Looking for McKenzie in the middle, just finds him as well, just past the post. McKenzie takes over, shot comes in, hits the post! Unbelievable effort at the end of the first period, and Brown covers up with a save.
That was an unbelievable effort, and that really all came through Jeff Hutchins there, making that pass to Barry McKenzie.
Scores! Right on the doorstep there. It's Dundee Stars 2, Hull Stingrays 2 with 16 minutes and 20 seconds to go in the second period.
Well, that was a great bit of play from John Mitchell there. Signed from the Portland Pirates, of course. And he does have experience playing for three AHL teams, Dave.
Yeah, and it's shown tonight, isn't it?
It really is, indeed.
For me, he's been a standout player for Dundee so far tonight in this game as well.
Just a player with that little bit of quality that you need in the times when it's a little bit tough, shall we say. Thank you.
exchanging the pass for Blake out to the blue line. McCluskey shoots.
Everybody just sliding all over the place there.
Yeah, McCluskey, I think, broken stick there as well. The boys kept it quick down the left-hand side. Scores for the Dundee Stars! Down the left-hand side, plays it in to the crease, and it's tipped in from right beside the goalie. It's Dundee Stars 3, Hull Stingrays 2, on the power play, with 5 minutes and 43 seconds remaining in the second period.
Well, they certainly made use of that power play situation there. Now put themselves ahead. This will be an interesting one for the Dundee Stars now. Will they be able to capitalise on that and move forward? Or have Hull got something to say?
Yep. I think it might have been Barry McKenzie for that goal there right on the doorstep. I guess we'll find out soon enough. Stingrays across the line, Meyer gets the shot away as well, hits the bar. Bounces off and out to the other side. McKenzie cleans up the Stars off the boards for Hutchins. It's kept in the zone though. Hutchins has tried to move out. Still kept in this time. Kevin Quick got a stick on the lead one. Chance for chance in front. Scores for the Stingrays. Stars all at sea in defence. And Meyer sticks it high above Cheverie to make the score. Dundee 3, Hull 3 with 1 minute 54 to go in the second period.
Well, there you have it. Defensive mistakes proving costly for the Dundee Stars. 3-3 with 1 minute and 54 left. It's any man's game.
Stingrays out the zone. Chance here for the Stars, it's Lust in on the goalie. Save, the rebound goes in though. The rebound popped out and Lust was there to tap it home. All of a sudden it's the Dundee Stars in the lead again. It's Dundee Stars 4, Hull Stingrays 3 with 1 minute and 15 to go in the second period.
Well, I don't think anybody could question the strength Dundee have going forward. That was an impressive goal. A bit of grit and determination there from the Dundee Stars as well, showing themselves as a real unit going forward. The question is, can they keep a hold of that and build on it, or will the Hull Stingrays maybe exploit their defensive woes a little bit?
Dundee go back to full strength, blows on, gets a shot away as well into the glove of Cheverie. Good save there from the Dundee goalie. Kept in the zone by Chartrain. Here go the Stars though, it's Matt Ryan, the Stars assistant coach. Gets a shot away, that's just wide of the target. Here come the Stingrays again, Galbraith across the line. Finds Lauzon, Lauzon moves in close, round the back of the net. Chance in front, loose, just past the post there, and Kevin Quick will get there first for the Stars, and it's out the zone.
Just gives the Dundee Stars a little bit of breathing space as we enter the last 35 seconds or so of the game.
Well, Stingrays need to keep the puck now as they've pulled the goalie. They've got six skaters on in favour of the goaltender. Dundee Stars free to fire it on target. Stingrays though, in pressure, in the zone, that's wider a target by Osman. Arvato in close and scores! Arvato right in the death of the game, 14.8 seconds to go, and the Stingrays score an equaliser. It's 4-4.
Well, if there was ever a time you wanted to score, it was then, wasn't it? The Hull Stingrays players, I don't think shocked on the bench, but certainly happy with that, delighted.
And it's that man again, Herbato. He's been dangerous tonight, no question about it. And he's punished the Stars there. he has the extra skater on. The Stingrays took advantage.
Extra skater on, and it's, I think Dundee have to play till the final seconds of the game. Clear the puck away, and they just failed to do it there.
Overtime period then underway, 4-on-4 for 5 minutes to find a winner. Extra space on the ice for the skaters to take advantage of. Here go the Stingrays. Mayer is through, he's gone right through the defence and scores! 14 seconds in overtime have come and gone, and the Stingrays take the extra point. Dundee Stars 4, Hull Stingrays 5 is a final score this evening, and the Stingrays celebrate.
Well, they celebrate and they have every right to. Dundee just switched off again there.
Well, that'll be that then. If I had to hazard a guess for men of the match, I'm saying Harvato for the Stingrays and Mitchell for Dundee. What do you think, Steve?
I would definitely agree with you with that. Hull Stingrays player has been ever present in the lineup tonight and has scored goals. And again, John Mitchell, you've got to say, commanded that Dundee line, Dave.
Man of the match this evening, sponsored by Mark Jackson, is number 24, John Mitchell.